Antibiotics save lives, but when you give an antibiotic, it has an effect on the infection you want to treat, but also on the gut microbiota ecosystem. Giving an antibiotic in early life increases the risk to develop some immune disease like allergy, eczema, asthma, inflammatory bowel disease, celiac disease, type 1 diabetes, and so on, as well as metabolic disease like obesity. Obviously, these diseases are multifactorial, and the antibiotic in early life increases the risk in susceptible individuals. So the first thing you have to think about is my antibiotic mandatory or not? If it is, you have to choose the antibiotics with the narrower spectrum to have the lesser impact on the gut microbiota community. And in case of the antibiotic is prescribed because it's mandatory, you can give some probiotics to prevent the disruption of the gut microbiota due to the antibiotic. When you have to give an antibiotic to a children, you have to bear in mind that its microbiota is still emerging, is unstable, it's less resistant and less resilient than an adult one. So it's very important to prevent the disruption of the gut microbiota during an antibiotic courses. Antibiotic-associated diarrhea is very common, and everyone has this experience. But it's more frequent, more common in infants because their microbiota is unstable and it's not as resistant as the adult one. So it concerns about 20% of infants under the age of 2 years. When you decide to prescribe a probiotic to prevent the antibiotic-associated diarrhea, you have to choose wisely your strain because every single strain has different properties. And you have to choose a strain that has demonstrated the evidence to be effective in this indication. To date, the two strains that are effective are Lactobacillus rhamnosus GG and Saccharomyces boulardii in children.